Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier, and in my this particular video I am going to discuss the concept of bit plane slicing in image processing, okay, using MATLAB. I'll be showing. So what is this concept? This is very simple. If you have studied digital logic design, then you might know what is LSB and MSB in a binary representation of a decimal number. If you don't know, please check that first in Google, you will find that easily. Okay, understand the concept of LSB, MSB, how to convert a decimal number to binary. Okay, because those concepts will help you to understand this particular concept. Okay, so the gray level of each pixel in digital image is stored as one or more bytes in a computer. What is byte? Byte is nothing but 8 bit. Okay, bit is 0 or 1. Okay. For an 8-bit image, 0 is encoded as 00000000, that is 8 zeros, and 255 is encoded as 11111111. Okay, so basically fundamental idea, as you know, that in case of grayscale image, minimum intensity level is 0, maximum intensity level is 255, and if you are considering UINT8, that is unsigned integer with 8-bit representation, then in that case, each pixel is represented with 8 bit, that is 1 byte, and that is like this, minimum and maximum intensity level like this. Okay, now any number between 0 to 255 is encoded as 1 byte. Okay, now I am talking about UINT8, that is 8 bit image system. Okay, bit plane slicing is a method of representing an image with one or more bits of the byte used for each pixels. Okay, that means what? In the bit plane slicing technique, what do we do? Instead of representing the intensity with its actual value, what we do? We take its binary representation. We'll be having some values 1 or set bits, and some bits will be 0. From there we extract certain bits. Suppose from all the pixels we take only 5th bit or 6th bit or the LSB or the MSB, does not matter, any bit we can check take, and then if we represent using those bits only, if we represent our image using those bits only, that is called bit plane slicing. If you check this particular image, you can understand. See, original 8 bit image intensity. So bit 0, lowest significant, then bit 1, bit 2, bit 3, bit 4, up to bit 7, which is most significant bit. If you take any of the bit, or maybe any combination, maybe most significant bit, 4th bit and 3rd bit, you can take according to your choice. Does not matter, you can take any combination of that actually. Okay. And using those, if you represent your image, that is called bit plane slicing. Okay. Now, with this fundamental concept of theoretical background, we are good to go with MATLAB programming. So see, what is bit plane slicing? If I show you one example, suppose this is our grayscale image, which is 2x2. Okay, some rows, some columns. Now what we do? We take binary representation of each individual pixel intensity. 6 binary representation, you know 110. 7, you know 111. Suppose this 4, you know 100. Okay, this 1, 001. Like that, for all the pixel intensities, we take its corresponding binary representation. I have shown here using 3 bit, but actually, if you have taken UINT8, that is unsigned integer 8 bit representation of image, then each pixel binary representation will have 8 bits. Now, you know that leftmost bit is the MSB and rightmost bit is the LSB. Now suppose you extract all the MSB, like here 1, then 1, then 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and so on. If you extract all the MSB, you will be having this particular pixel. Now you convert this to image. Okay, you apply IM show on this. Whatever you will be getting, that will be image corresponding to MSB of the pixels. Then suppose you extract all the central pixel, you will be having this image. You extract all the LSB pixels, you will be having this image. Okay, now one thing is clear to you, as this is having only 1 and 0. So this will convert, this bit plane slicing will convert grayscale image to binary image. And this is the most widely used application part of bit plane slicing. Okay, that is converting grayscale to binary. Now let us take the MATLAB implementation. Okay, so before going to MATLAB code for bit plane slicing, let us see some fundamental concept related to decimal to binary conversion of a matrix. Okay, suppose I am having one very small matrix 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, you can consider these elements as pixel values for your grayscale image. Now, suppose I want to convert these numbers, these elements of this particular matrix A from decimal to binary. So in digital communication system, we have studied deck to bin operation, right? If you click enter, see, you will be getting one column matrix, not like actual input matrix you will be getting output. It is actually giving us one column vector, okay? And if you check the pattern, how it is returning, see, this is our original input, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3 in first row, 4, 5 in second row. But it is giving column wise, 2, 4, binary representation of 2 is 0, 1, 0, binary representation of 4 is 1, 0, 0, binary representation of 3 is 0, 1, 1, binary representation of 5 is 1, 0, 1. So, first it is giving all the binary representation of first column, then next column, like that it is giving, right? So, suppose I want to go back from binary to decimal, if you simply write bin to deck of our ants, because it's in ants variable binary representation is stored, if you click enter, you'll be getting 2435. And this is not actually our input matrix, okay? Our input matrix is 2345. So for that, what we can do? Resize, okay, or reshape. Reshape A comma two rows, two columns I want. So what it will do? Take first two elements, we'll make the first column. Then it will go to next two elements and it will make in the second column. So it will form two rows, two columns, okay? See, 2345, like that, okay? So this is the fundamental concept. But there is one problem. That is, suppose I am writing deck to bin of 5, I am getting one character vector, 101, character output, 101. But extracting elements from this will be another headache in programming. So there is another function, de to bin. Okay, that is deck to bin only, but de to bi. That is just remove C and remove N. That's all. Now, if I write 5, what it will give? It will give me 101. Okay, as what? Individual elements, different columns. Okay, suppose I am writing 4. Okay, see 001. So what it indicates? NSB in the left hand side. That yes, leftmost side. MSB in the rightmost side. That is opposite of general convention. 3 I am writing 11. Okay, then suppose 10 I am writing 0101. But actually it is 1010, so MSB is in this side. So we can use this DE to BI to implement our bit plane slicing, because that will be easier, because we are getting as individual element instead of character output. Okay, so here is the simple code which will be posted in the description box also. CLC clear all closure warning of A equal to RGB to gray IM read papers dot PNG. If I show you the image, IM show A, I'll be having one beautiful image of peppers, onions and chilies, okay, which is very popular in color image processing. We widely use this, okay. Then I am computing the size of this for reshaping purpose, as I have shown you that while performing decimal to binary representation, it always gives us in resized format. So that is column vector it returns. So to get back the original shape, we need reshape. So for that, we need to calculate the dimension of the input matrix, and that is M, N. Then I am converting the original matrix to double. Okay, this is not IM to double. This is simple double. What it will do? Our image is unsigned integer 8 representation, but this DE to BI converts from decimal to binary, not unsigned integer to binary. So we are converting or type casting from unsigned integer to decimal, okay, using double. And there is one more function, IM to double. What that does, that basically maps our input intensity level within 0 to 1. That is different. Suppose our intensity level is 255 somewhere. you will be getting same using double also. Let me show you. Suppose I am running this particular part, and suppose I am writing a of 1, 1, which is our unsigned integer representation, which is 43. Now, if I write b of 1, 1, of which is after getting double of a, c will be also getting 43. But this is double and this is uint 8, that is unsigned integer. Why we are converting to double? Because de to bi works on double. So we are converting to double, and then as you know, the in case of MATLAB, the index starts from 1 and the leftmost side is LSB, that is least significant bit, rightmost side is MSB after operating DE to BI, as I have shown you. So I am extracting the first LSB, then second bit, that is colon, comma 2, that is all rows second column, then all rows third column, that is third bit, all rows fourth column, then fourth bit, all rows fifth column, that is fifth bit, all rows sixth column, that is sixth bit, all rows seventh column, that is seventh bit, all rows eighth column, that means eighth bit. So as our representation having only 8 bits, so now this is done. Now each time we need to perform reshape operation having same dimension as of our original matrix or original image, okay? Because you have seen that it returns as column vector, but we need to resize that or reshape that to our original matrix size. Like I have shown you, for 2 cross 2 input, we need to map to 2, 2, okay? Same, apply the same reshaping operation for all the bit plane and then plot that, okay? Subplot 2, 4, 1, IM show R1, title LSB bit plane, then second bit plane, third bit plane, like that MSB bit plane also. Okay. If I run evaluate selection, I'll be having this particular output where this is LSB bit plane. We can clearly understand the name itself signifies least significant bit, LSB. See, this is least significant only. That's why we are unable to understand what is our actual image. But if you go to MSB bit plane, we can clearly understand. Seventh bit also, we can have a clear idea about our image. Okay, this is LSB bit plane, second bit plane, third bit plane, fourth bit plane, and so on. This is our MSB bit plane. Okay, so this is what about bit plane slicing in MATLAB. Simple idea, just you need to know DE2BI inbuilt function, along with that this particular operation which is very, very important, that is reshape. Okay, these two documentation link I'll be posting in the description box. Check that. Along with that, same code will be posted in the description box. If you want, you can check that and apply in your project. So this is all for this video. Thank you for watching.